Volám sa Lucia Nimcova. Študovala som na inštitúte tvorčí fotografie v Opave, ešte predtým na šupke v Košiciach. Vždy odbor fotografiu, ktorou sa akože primárne vyjadrujem a ktorá mi je najbližšia. Mňa vlastne odjakživa vždycky ovplyvňovala najviac literatúra, lebo to bolo asi najjednoduchšie, k čomu sa dalo dostať ako v miestnej knižnici. A potom neskôr vôbec tak, akože kdekoľvek sa človek môže dostať do knižnice. Všade majú nejakú knižnicu, takže Dostojevský, potom neskôr Thomas Bernhard a Svetlana Alexievič. But instant moment really helped me to have a chance to talk to many women and just learn from their own experiences. You know, and they're mostly my generation. And of course, after that, I started to be more and more interested in old women in Eastern Europe. Because they went through everything. And they were one who survived everything, you know. And they, some of them, they have such a incredible humor, you know, in their lives and sharing energy that I'm fascinated by. Another was Double Coding, which was about Slovak band movies. And I basically wanted to see what was banned from us from 68 till 89 and why. You know, I wanted to understand the process of how something is problematic. If it is paid by state, it went through 5 different committees. In some cases, even million people saw it already, and then they were banned, right? So I tried to watch all the banned movies, fiction, not some documentaries, but my main research were fiction movies, which in fact were showing reality. And then going through that process, I decided to become a censor myself, and I censored a few seconds from all banned movies, and I created my own installation where you can walk in and be surrounded by these images. So that's why I later on started to work on projects, unofficial, where I was trying to kind of see how life went in a period of 20 years in my hometown, during the same events, at the same places, with the same people, over and over again, being photographed by official photographer, you know. So I studied that archive, and then I continue the same work nowadays. So I went to the same places, photographed the same people, I try to use the same visual language, you know, just to show that system cannot change from one day to the other. It takes very long time, you know, to change something. So it was same for the Baika in Ukraine, that I went to record folk opera and before doing just a couple of videos. So I had to learn, I had to find the people, and the people were topic. So I had the idea, but then I had to kind of fulfill it, and I've done it in 2014 when the war in Ukraine started, because I wanted to be there, I wanted to talk to people, you know, like I wanted to know how they feel and what is actually happening on the battle lines of everyday life, not at the war line, you know, because the war is always present in a normal life, but how does it look, you know. So that's why I basically done it, and you realize that history is always repeating itself, you know, and in Ukraine especially. So all these songs, they would be describing events from First World War or Second World War or after the war or even during the communism, and somehow they share the same tragedies, you know, same losses, but also like hate, love, you know, sex and everything, what is part of the life,